To move a grounded houseboat went nowhere fast today. The city of Holly Hill is in a legal dispute with the boat's owner. It's been stuck in the sand in the Intracoastal waterway for months. When the owner failed to move it, the city took custody. WESH 2's Claire Metz joins us live now. And Claire, the city hasn't had any luck getting it moved either.
Well, Jim, they plan to try again tomorrow when they can still take advantage of a lunar high tide. That's the houseboat right there, stuck on a little island just off this one. Now, the owner, who, as you'll recall, was once arrested for threatening anyone who tried to board, was here much calmer today, but he is still not a very happy boater. For typically sleepy Holly Hill, this riverside show drew quite a crowd, including owner Robert McGarry, who watched as a city-hired salvage team tried to refloat the 52-foot houseboat.
I have no confidence in what they're doing. So if they rip the hull, that's a $250,000 replacement on that boat.
McGarry and his ship came in during an October storm, and with no money to move it, he sat on board, being repeatedly cited, building up fines. Because of growing environmental concerns, the city got the legal okay to impound the boat and have it towed.
I got into this business to help people, not displace them from their home.
City officials say they take no pleasure in taking the boat. They say they worked with McGarry as much as they could, but finally had to act. And they still hope if McGarry can come up with the costs of salvage, he gets the houseboat back.
The best case scenario is that Mr. McGarry is able to reclaim his boat and sail off into the sunset, as it were.
But McGarry won't go quietly. He still believes this is an unlawful seizure and says he'll take his case to the Florida Supreme Court. You may recall earlier in this drama, McGarry was arrested for threatening to use force against anyone who boarded, including police. Well, those same officers took up a collection for McGarry.
At first, I told him, no, I don't want your money, you know, and then I took it, you know, because quite frankly, they should. And they're the ones that made me homeless.
Back live now, once the houseboat is refloated and it will be taken into dry dock, McGarry will have 30 days from then to come up with all the expense related to the salvage and the storage. If he does not, the city will have the right to auction his houseboat. Reporting live in Holly Hill, Volusia County, Claire Metz, WESH 2 News.